Fallout 3 Broken Steel. This is Rebel Link, and this is video 2. Before I talk about the game, I put the song in the description, and that way I'll get asked a million times what song is in the beginning of my intros. So it's a Team Sleep song called Natalie Portman. It's a really good song. Anyways, so what we're going to be doing is trekking over to the far southwest corner of the map. And really, it's just Bethesda's neat way to port you over to a map outside of the wasteland. So that's cool how they do that. Hopefully you guys have played Operation Anchorage and have this rifle, the Gauss rifle, sniper rifle, because you're going to be using it a lot. Because once you download Broken Steel, and let's say you are a higher level, like right now I think I'm at 25. I'm actually at 30 already in my other, my main save through, but you know, for this walkthrough, you'll see me at 25 and progressing up. Anyway, you also get to download the new enemies. Yippee! And tell you what, just as I've been bitching about some of my other videos, those enemies are really tough. So a combination that I've been using a lot lately is what I call the Gauss Fox combo. So it sounds just as it means. You're using a combination of the Gauss rifle, which deals out damage pretty good. But more importantly, what it does is it knocks enemies on their ass it knocks them unconscious basically for about, I'd say 5 seconds or so. As long as Fox is with you, he'll be burying bullets into, you know, whatever enemy you're going to be attacking. So, when, the other thing too, if you have the Chinese assault rifle, Chinese sneaking suit or recon armor, we're going to be using that a bit too to you know, get in the crouch mode and try and take as much off of these harder enemies as we can, much health as we can off these harder enemies. So, just going off the top of my head, there's the albino scorpions. There's the tougher mutants, super mutants. I think it's called Super Mutant Colossus or something. And what else? Oh, the ghoul. To me, for whatever reason, those ghouls are the hardest things to put down. So, the good thing about Fox is, just as I mentioned before, is that he can take a lot of damage. So, bringing him along is essential. Otherwise, all of those freaking enemies are going to be concentrating on you. Like, you don't want that. I've never been in these side rooms before, so I kind of ventured into them just to see if there's anything relevant that you guys should see, but there wasn't. And I haven't talked to any of these guys in the room besides this cat here, but I would imagine maybe some of these people could repair equipment if you need repairing. I know there's health packs laying around if you're low on those and whatnot, so stock up when you can, because these levels aren't easy. Especially if you've been hoarding a lot of stuff in your house, like stim packs, mainly stim packs, anything health related, you definitely want to go get. By the way, I'm wearing the Enclave, the new armor that you run into, the Hellfire Enclave, because their damage resistance is almost at 50. It's at 49. I think 50 when it's perfectly repaired, or 49. Whatever, the wiki will tell you. But it's pretty good armor. I carry around with me, because guess what, you're going to be running into a lot of those Hellfire enclaves, so you know, might as well use their armor to repair your armor, right? So good idea, just stick with that. So this is a pretty neat scene here with Liberty Prime kicking some ass, and obviously it's the intro of the video that I use for this these series of walkthroughs. Oh, which, by the way, I got a comment, a couple comments from a few people asking me to do a tutorial on how I do my intros. They're not too hard. Just gotta be a little imaginative. Really, I mean, if you're using like Sony Vegas or Adobe, you know, just, they're not really complicated. I probably put them together in a matter of like 30 minutes or so. But I don't know. I may do one sometime. Not sure. We'll see. Oh, by the way, thank you to everybody who watched my Call of Duty 4 montage. Just like I mentioned before, I do those for fun, just on the side. Looks like you guys like the second montage a lot more than the first one, which I agree. I mean, the first one I was just kind of, literally that was gameplay from a matter of little hours and whatnot. So, the second one I put a little bit more content together, a couple days, about a day and a half recording. So I'm glad you liked it. And of course I'll be continuing to do those down the road. Not anytime soon, but you'll see those pop up. Alright, so as you just saw, Liberty Prime has been getting killed. And it's funny, it's kind of, there's a glitch that's about here. This guy just randomly appears out of nowhere. Okay. And then he goes into seizure mode, which isn't a fun thing to see, by the way, if you've ever seen somebody have a seizure. So, anyways, this is the end of our second video. Next video, we're going to be storming this building and taking out all the enclave in it. See you guys.